Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Here are a few more examples doing lattice multiplication to multiply whole numbers. All right, so let's try another one. How about a three-digit times a three-digit? How about 469 times 207? And there's two ways we could do this because it depends which number goes across the top and which number goes across the side, but this is going to be a 3 by 3 in any case, so we have to make boxes where there's 3 by 3. All right, so let's say we just wrote the 469 across the top and the 207 across the side. And then we put in our diagonals for the lattice. Now, the only reason you might want to also do it the other way, it's kind of easy to check your answer if you do the multiplication putting the 207 across the top. And if you get the same answer, then it's a better chance that you did it correctly. You could make the same mistake twice, of course, like doing a multiplication wrong inside. So let's say I put the 207 across the top, that would also be okay. Right, so let's fill the numbers in here. Go ahead and try this on your own first. And this is part two of lattice multiplication, so if you don't know how to do it, you might want to look at part one first. 9 times 2 is 18. We do 6 times 2 is 12. 4 times 2 is 8. And remember to put the 8 here, not up here. If you want to fill in something, put a 0 up there. 9 times 0, okay, you can leave that blank or put 2 zeros. In fact, 0 times anything is going to be 0, isn't it? All of these will be zeros. 9 times 7 is 63. 6 times 7 is 42. And 4 times 7 is 28. And then I showed you a way of just drawing cups if you want to. Just be careful. You can do this, but you don't have to do that. All right, so then we take the numbers in the lattice and they fall in the cup. So 3 falls in here. 6 and 2 add up to 8. That goes in here. Now we have 8, 4, and 8. So what's that add up to? That adds up to 20. So remember, you have to write 20. You have to put the 2 over here. That's the carry. There's your 20. See it? 2, 0. Or 0 carry the 2, however you want to think about it. Then we've got 1, 2, 2, and 2. That's 7. And 1 and 8 is 9. And we don't have any number up here at top. You don't need to write the 0. So we just read, starting at the top left, read around. This answer is 97,083. All right, let's do it. With the 207 across the top. Might want to put this video on pause and try it on your own first. So we have, doesn't matter where we start with our multiplications. 2 times 4 is 8. Remember to put the 8 here. And if you want, you can put a 0 here or leave it blank. Now I have 0 times 4. That's just going to be 0. In fact, 0 times all these numbers are going to be 0. So this whole column is going to be 0. So we have 7 times 4 is 28. 7 times 6 is 42. 7 times 9 is 63. All right, we have to fill in these boxes. 2 times 6 is 12. And 2 times 9 is 18. So I filled those in. And I'm going to fill these in. 3 falls into here. 2 and 6 is 8. Along this diagonal, I have 8, 4, and 8. That is 20, so I'm going to have 20, 2, 0, because the 2 gets carried up to this next part. So 2, 2, 1, and 2, that's 7. That's 9, and there's nothing in this first one. You can put a 0, and if you read it, you've got 97,083. Same answer. So I think that's the correct answer for 469 times 207. Now, this does take more space on the paper, but the cool thing about lattice multiplication is you don't have all that carrying going on, where you have to multiply plus add the carry at the same time. The way we do normal traditional multiplication is just trying to write it in less space, basically. So, for instance, if you see how you do normal multiplication for 69, so we've got 9 times 6. So a lot of people get confused, first of all, and write for 63, they'll put 6, 3. See, there's one mistake a lot of people make. Okay. So we're trying to eliminate. But actually, it's 63, so people put the 3, then they carry the 6, and then you have 7 times 6, which is 42. You got to keep that in your head, and then add 6. Then you have to think, what was that? 42 plus 6. Oh, that's 48. Remember, you have to put the 8 and carry the 4. There's a lot going on in your head, in other words. Where in the lattice multiplication, all you're doing is doing a bunch of multiplication first and then a bunch of addition at the end. Let's keep going. So now I have to do 4, 7 times 4 is 28. I have to keep that in my head. 28 plus 4. Okay, 28 plus 4, 32. So you write 32. This is hard for a lot of people. Now, 0 times all the rest of them is just going to be a bunch of zeros, so you could leave that off. And we do the same thing with 2 times 9. We go across. 2 times 9 is 18. But now it's confusing because you had this one here. That's confusing for the carrying. So you have 2 times 6 is 12. You got to carry that 1, not the 6, right? And 12 times 6 is 12 plus 1 is 13. 1, carry the 1. That's confusing because that 4 is there. Then you have 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1 is 9. Now we have to add. So 3, 8, 2 and 8 is 10, then you got to carry this. Then you have 3 and 3 and 1 is 7. And see how you get the same answer? Okay, it takes a little bit less space. I maintain it's more confusing and more people make mistakes using regular multiplication. Although, you know, if you've done it hundreds or thousands of times, you know, you get pretty good at it. Like, I'm pretty good at doing this multiplication this way, and I have to admit, I still do it that way most of the time because I've done it so many times. I'm really proficient at it. But I personally think we should teach everybody the lattice method. I think it's better to use a little bit more paper and not, you know, make it so difficult on our brains, and we make less mistakes, fewer mistakes. Okay, so that's my opinion about lattice multiplication. How about you try one more problem? All right, so here's one for you to try. 32 times 26, and how about trying it both ways, where the 32 is across the top and then where the 26 is across the top. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, it's a two digit by a two digit, so we have to have two boxes by two boxes. There are always two ways to do it, depending on which number you want to put across the top and which number you want to put along the right side. So let's do 32 times 26, and then we'll do 26 times 32. Right, 3 times 2 is 6. 2 times 2 is 4. Now notice I'm not putting the zeros, but you can put a zero there. Make sure you don't put 40 because then that would be saying 2 times 2 is 40. All right, 2 times 6 is 12. And remember, this really does stand for 2 times 20, which is 40, but you've already got the 4 in the right place value. That's the tens place value. Keep in mind that's the ones, the tens, the hundreds, the thousands. And the last one, 3 times 6 is 18. All right, let's fill these into their cups. Let's not put cups. Let's just do it without cups this time. The 2 falls in here. All right. Now on the next line here, we've got 4, 1, and 8. That is 13, so I could put 3, carry the 1, or I like to put 1, 3 for 13. 6, 1, and 1 is 8. So it looks like the answer, read around, is 832. If you would have put cups in, it would look like this. It's up to you, whether you like that or not. Okay, let's go over here and do same thing. 6 times 3 is 18. 2 times 3 is 6. Remember that's 0, 6. 6 times 2 is 12. 2 times 4 is 4, so write 0, 4. And okay, just to be different, let's put the cups in for those people that like to see it like that. Got two falls into here. 8, 1, and 4 is 13, so I'm going to write that as 3 carry the 1, but I could write the 1 first. Basically, C13, see it's there? See over here, 13? You got it. And 1, 6, and 6 is 8, and you don't have to write the 0 here, but you can. And again, reading top left and going around, we get 832. And that's all there is to it. Those of you who want to know how to do it with decimals, you could look at my video for lattice multiplication with decimals. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.